And GripperSpotTech is something which is an add-on software with a special functionality. It's a technology package for control and configuration of grippers. What I mean with this is that it's an option for us to control grippers, which you of course can do even without this option. Of course, if you have a gripper or a spot welding tool or anything like this in your application, that is totally controllable either from the robot program itself or quite commonly also a PLC program which controls the gripper. But with GripperSpotTech, we can control it independently of either the robot program or the PLC program, which is pretty useful because we don't need to know exactly which IOs there are. We don't need to know where in the program the gripper is handled, but we can control it directly from the smart pad and without knowing the structure and open or close our grippers at any time, independently of where the different program cycles are. So actually, I'm going to leave the word over to my colleague. We are experiencing a little bit of a technical problem of his microphone, so we will see if that starts off with or not. Just a short info that what we actually then can do, what you will see it or experience GripperSpotTech is directly on the smart pad and the four customizable keys that's on the furthest down to on the smart pad, where we can define a number of tools and we can define actions for the buttons. For example, open and close the gripper. So this is then handled in this way. And of course, we also need to have the dead man's grip enabled to do these operations. Today, my colleague Andreas Varga will show us live how this is configured and handled. But I hope I see he's in the meeting. But if it's okay, we will try to switch over to his screen.
All right. Yes, can you hear me? That's a good start. Let's see if you can see my screen as well. All right, here it is. So I'm going to start by showing you what it looks like when you're done with the configuration. So we are talking about these four tech keys on the left side. They can be assigned to different grippers and different functions. In this case, we have a gripper with three positions. It's a servo gripper. I have a welding gun as well, which can be open and closed. There's a tool changer, which can be open and closed, and also the lids or the covers of the tool changer with two of them. So all of them are configured using GripperSpotTech. So there's two ways to do the configuration. One way is directly on the smart pad, as shown here. The other way, in my opinion, more convenient way, is to do that in Work Visual instead. So I'm connected to the robot that we have down here in the tech center. I'm going to open that one up and show you how the configuration is done in Work Visual. So like I said, do the configuration in official. If you need to do any adjustments or anything, that can be done on the smart as well. That's usually my work. All right. So my robot, here are all the options for the robot I have here, and we are going to take a look at the GripperSpotTech. So here are all the grippers. We can create up to 16 different grippers. I had used 5 of them. The things you have to do, you have to assign a name, select if it's going to be active or not. And the reason why you have to do this is because you can export, if you have, let's say, a production line with a bunch of robots with different grippers on them, you can create a gripper configuration that includes all the grippers, and you can export that from one project and import it to the next one. And then you can just select which one you want to be active for the robot in mind. Okay, so the gripper also has to have a switching state. In this case, it will be open halfway, and closed. We can also have a number of inputs. Those will be feedback we click on the gripper. Let's say, hey, I'm actually open or I'm actually closed. There's possibility of up to 6 switching states and 6 inputs. Oh, sorry, that's outputs. 6 inputs as well. So outputs is having the signal to gripper. The input is receiving the confirmation. There's a gripper icon as well. There's a bunch of them already in here. If you want to create your own, you're free to do that as long as you stick to 32 by 32 pixels. There are function to check if the gripper has fulfilled the requirement. Let's say you get the feedback signal or not. And there's a timeout for that. And you can set that timeout here. Also, you can set a signal high, or you can just pulse it. And the pulse duration, if you use the pulsing, is set here. The next tab is the states and IOs. So my icon for the open, I pick an open gripper, and for the halfway closed, I pick the halfway closed icon and closed for the closed one. And then you can give them whatever names you like as well. There are 2 types of buttons. You will do the default one. That means if you click the button, whatever it's assigned to do, it will do that. If you select it as critical, you have to push the button twice with the button second in between. And you might want to do that, for example, if you have a tool changer which has no feedback or anything, you don't want that to be opened by mistake when you drop the tool. Next one are all the outputs. So I use output 400, 401, and 402 to open, have it close, and close the gripper. And I set them high. Whenever I push the button, I have the possibility to pulse as well. And the pulse duration is set on the tab, for this tab. We also have the possibility for inputs. In this case, I have my inputs on the gripper. So I just use the simulated. Look, it's a predefined input that is always low. And you have a checkbox here if you want to be able to simulate the input or not. In this case, it doesn't matter. But you might want to be able to decide that. And the next tab is the mapping. So if I push the open state, then I want the signal output 400 to the high, 401 to the low, and 402 to the low. And for the middle position, I want output 400 to the low, and 401 to the high, and 402 to the low. So that's how you build up your functions. And then we have the input mapping. In this case, I'm not even using them, so they're false. That signal is always false. You also have possibility to have preconditions for manual operation. So if I select this input has to be true in order for me to manually open the gripper. And that can also be a link to functions which are basically created in KUKA code. Do you want to go advanced? Next is the parameters. We have something called ghost mode that can be enabled from an input from a PLC. So in ghost mode, inputs and outputs are similar there, depending on the configuration. And if I have an error, I can set an output for errors. So the higher level controller knows there's an error. And also I have three different error strategies. And they can be either stop the robot completely, pop up a dialogue where the user has the possibility to either stop the robot, retry, or ignore, just continue the program. And you can choose if that dialogue is available in test one, test two mode, test one, test two, and automatic, test one, test two, automatic, and automatic external. Or you can use your create your own user strategies, also in KUKA code. Last but not least, there's the data and icons tab. We can save our configuration from a project in this robot, and we can load it onto a different one. We also have the possibility to, in a simple way, organize our grippers. So I can swap them around if I want the server gripper to have a different number, for example. And I can also import icons if I want to and use my own icons in my own configuration. So just to show you what it looks like on Smarthead instead, it's very much similar. Same functionality, same settings. Same tab here, state scenarios, and the last one is the mapping. So you can pick whatever is most comfortable for you to use. So when we have our groupers configured, there's also a page here that is available to us called GripperSpotTech, and that will show you a full screen window with the different grippers and also the signal states. So in this case, I have the OK to run. That's the input from the tool changer that I can open it right now. So all I have to do is press the deadness switch and press the open button and the close button. This can be convenient for troubleshooting it. And also, when you have configured your grippers, you will have inline forms made for you based on your information from the gripper configuration. So you can use them when you do your normal KUKA programming. And they are in the commands, gripper type. And you can, for example, set gripper. You pick which gripper you want to use. You select the state if I want to open it. If I want to do that while moving, or if I want to stand still while opening it. For how long we're going to wait. And if we want to do any check if it's open or not. Also, we have our strategies here. The next one here is the gripper synchronous set. So we can synchronize our gripper actions in relation to a start point or end point along the path. And we can also delay that in relation to those positions. For example, if we want to open the gripper, but let's say for the glue gun, you want to start the heating of the glue gun so it's heated before you actually come to the spot where you want to glue, for example. And then we have the possibility to just check the gripper. You want to check if the state is open. That is particularly good for tool changer. We want to make sure that the tool changer is open before we try to enter the gripper and pick it up. And that can also be done as a synchronous motion, asynchronous check. Do we have any questions so far? There's nothing in the chat. So unless there's any questions popping up, I'm going to give the word over to Michael again.
Okay, thank you a lot, Andreas. If there are any questions, please enter them in the chat window on the right hand, and we'll, after a few seconds, we will see them. So what we tried to show you here is actually one of our most sold add-on tools here, which significantly makes life easier during commissioning or error handling, or when you take out new positions for your robot, for example, because that means that you don't have to have a knowledge of the PLC or robot program structure or where the outputs are, but you can handle the gripper directly, whatever state the PLC or robot program is on. And with that, we thank you for your attentions. We hope for questions and suggestions for future webinars. Don't forget that.